You may be seated as we have a moment to remember
those who we love, who are following Jesus, and will await us in heaven because they were promoted to glory in 2019. Probably appropriate for our theme today to be following Jesus, because the pictures and the names are reminders of those we love, spouses, family, friends who followed Jesus. And Thank you, Betty, for putting that together and for adding at the end, well done, good and faithful servants. Those of you who had a special connection to those pictures, please know that during our prayer time, we're going to be thinking of you and praying for you. A promotion to glory touches us deeply, gives us great hope, and yet our hearts are extremely tender and need the healing hand of God. When we're separated for a time from those that we love. And so please know you are in our hearts and our thoughts and our prayers today. The prayer chorus that we will sing is, "Where He Leads Me, I Will Follow. Where He Leads Me, I Will Follow." And we have several of us, part of our congregation, who are following Jesus, but need an extra prayer, an extra support, maybe an extra hug as they heal or as they struggle with anything in particular. So you'll see those on our prayer concerns on the back of the source. Know that Colonel Val Bate, her sister, passed away. She was close to her sister, and so please pray for Val, who has a hurting heart today. Her sister lived in New Zealand. And please remember Barbara Beatty, still in Mies Continuing Care in rehab, and Margaret Howell in Brookdale Healthcare. Our own Lieutenant Colonel Mary Petroff has got some health concerns. Please remember her. Marion Scott is back home, so you'll know that. She is back home. Continue to pray for her and strength. Major Bill Travis came through his surgery well, but he's in Brookdale Healthcare as well. And I'm sure he would love a visit, correct? Yeah, Major's visited a couple of times. So, and you'll notice towards the bottom of, on the left-hand side, baby Sophia Rose. She was born prematurely. She's the granddaughter of the Smiths, Ron and Lori. She's making progress. She's making progress. A lot of setbacks and then some progress, setbacks and progress. So please pray for that precious baby. June Gunther, we just found out this morning that she's in the ER. We don't know what ER right now, but they're checking her heart. So please remember June. Upcoming shoulder surgery for Lieutenant Colonel Connie Canning in February. So please remember her as she goes in for a reverse shoulder replacement. So, we pray for her speedy recovery. And then our armed forces, do not forget those on the right-hand side fighting to keep us free. The fires raging, I'm sure you've noticed that or heard that or read that about the fires raging in Australia. Please pray for the people there and the general unrest in our world. None of this is a surprise to God, and He is so close. He is the holy other, but then He's closer than our very breath at the same time. And so we bring all of these plus your concerns. If we went around and asked, "Hey, do you have a concern? Do you have a concern?" Unspoken, as spoken, we would all have prayer requests that we want to lift this morning to our Heavenly Father. So let's sing together, "Where He Leads Me, I Will Follow."
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, we know that it is your Holy Spirit who leads us, guides us, and helps us to follow, helps us to understand Scripture. And when we have a question or a decision, and it's very clear in your word, it's your Spirit that can just lead us there, remind us, there's your answer. When things are not so clear, you are there to comfort and still lead and still guide in our lives. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for working everywhere. You are comforting those who have a connection to those terrible raging fires in Australia. Your Spirit is working there. Your Spirit is working here. Your Spirit is working in the rehab centers and in the homes of those that we had mentioned, and in the ER rooms and in the hospitals. Your Spirit is working, and we can trust that. We can trust that you love each one of us. We can trust, Holy Spirit, that you are aware of each one of us. And that you're here now and always to teach us, to guide us, to remind us of all that Jesus has done, and to conform us into the likeness of Jesus. And on this day, when we remember those spouses and friends and family during this past year who have been promoted to glory, who are in heaven right now, who have seen Jesus, and who are waiting for us, we know your Spirit will bring comfort and healing to our hearts during this time where we are separated from the ones who we dearly, dearly loved. And so, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, we trust you as we follow you this day and always. In Jesus' name, amen.